Hello everyone, welcome back to another video lecture. In this video we are going to see some common shear force and bending moment diagrams on a simply supported beam with different kind of loading. Without any further delay, let's see some common bending moment and shear force diagrams. So here are some common relationship between load and shear force diagram, SFD, and bending moment diagram, BMD. So if the load is a point load, the shear force diagram will be constant. You can see this is a baseline. Top of this, it will be positive and negative, and it is constant with opposite sign. And in the case of bending moment, it will be a triangle. In case of the load will be uniformly distributed load, the shear force will be linear. Right, it's linear. Let's say this is positive and negative, and the bending moment diagram will be parabola, right? Parabolic shape. In case of the load, if the load will be uniformly varying load, so uniformly varying load, then the shear force will be parabolic and equal and opposite, parabolic shape. Parabolic shape, and the shear force, the bending moment diagram will be cubic, right? Cubic shape. So these are some common relationship between shear force and bending moment. If it is point load, it will be constant for shear force. For bending moment, it will be looks like a triangle, or you can call it as a linear triangle, right? And in case of UDL, the shear force will be linear, and in case of bending moment diagram, that is BMD, it will be looks like a parabolic. And if the loading is uniformly varying load, and the shear force diagram will be parabolic, and bending moment diagram will be looks like this. The next, we'll see the shear force bending moment diagram for a simply supported with point load. So let me write here. So shear force, I'll write in shortcut, that is SFD and BMD, shear force diagram and bending moment diagram for a simply supported beam with point load. At middle of the span, that is at middle point. So we'll try to derive this shear force bending moment for a simply supported beam with point load at middle. Right? Remember, the point load is acting at a middle. So let us draw this. There will be a vertical reaction, that is hinge support, and another one is roller. I'm drawing the free body diagram. Let's say this is A and B. Like I mentioned in the heading, the point load is acting at middle point. So this is a total length. So exactly middle, it will be L by 2, L by 2. Right? The load is acting at the middle of the span or middle of the beam. That is, let's say W. And this point, I will name it as C. Agree? So the first step is to calculate the support reactions. So we have two unknowns, that is RA and RB. So we know that summation of V, that is sigma V, equals to zero from equilibrium condition, right? So I can write as RA, which is upward direction, so positive, plus RB, which is also a vertical force. So RB equals to minus downward direction, that's why it's minus W equals to zero, right? From here I can write RA plus RB equals to W. Let's say this is the first equation. Now we'll take moment about A, taking moment about A. So like we know this, if you take moment at A, we are coming all the reactions, all the loads from B. So from left, from your right to left. So that is summation of moment A equals to zero. Okay. So I can know that from here, I can write RA, sorry, RB multiplied, that is support reaction into perpendicular distance. So load into perpendicular distance. So here is the perpendicular distance till A will be L minus downward direction W into the perpendicular distance from W to A will be L by 2. Right? So from here I can write RB into L equals to WL by 2. Right? So then here RB we can find out, that is RB equals to WL by 2 by L. LL get cancelled. RB equals to W by 2. Let us say this is equation number 2. So we got RB by taking moment about A and the summation of vertical reactions equals to 0. We got RA plus RB equals to W. Now I will put this in equation 1. I put RB in equation number 1. Okay, so we'll write here. In this equation, RB equals to W by 2, right? Substitute this in equation 1. We know that RB, RA plus RB equals to W. RA plus B, we know that RB is W by 2 equals to W. From here we know we can get RA equals to W minus W by 2, right? And that will be W by 2. Now, the second step, we calculated the support reaction, we know we got the RA and RB. Now, we will calculate the shear force. Shear force, that is denoted by capital F, will take shear force at point A, considering point A at A, that is FA equals to W by 2, right? We know that FA equals to RA. Shear force at A equals to reaction at A. So, that is why we know RA equals to LW by 2. So, shear force at A equals to W by 2. Now, shear force at B. Shear force at B will be FB equals to RA minus W. So, RA is positive and W is negative, showing downward direction. So, we got RA minus W, that is equals to W by 2 minus W. Here we get minus W by 2. So, RB will be minus W by 2. Clear? So, this is a beam. Point A and B. So, this is RA, RB. If you take any section, this is positive and this is a load acting here, that is will be negative. Okay. So, RB equals to W by 2 minus W, that is minus W, we got minus W by 2, right? Next, we will find out bending moment. Third step is to find out bending moment. Denoted by M. So, bending moment at A will be MA equals to, so this is a beam, so this is MA and we know that RA, RB, so we are coming from right to left, that will be RB multiplied by perpendicular distance, that is L minus, so next reaction will be W and the perpendicular distance will be L by 2, L by 2. So, minus sign because of downward direction, W multiplied by the perpendicular distance will be L by 2. Clear? From this we can know that W by 2, that is RB into L minus W L by 2. So, from this I can get W L by 2 minus W L by 2, right? Both are get cancelled. So, moment at A is 0. Bending moment at C. So, this is the C, so bending moment at C. What is bending moment at C? So, let us say MC equals to, so we are taking this coming from this direction, that will be R A multiplied by L by 2. You can take R B multiplied by L by 2 or else R A multiplied by L by 2. So that will be W by 2 multiplied by L by 2. So moment at C will give W L by 4. Right? Now we will find out the moment at B. Bending moment at B. So we have to come all the way from left to right. Right? So that is MB equals to RA multiplied by L minus W multiplied by L by 2. Right? Now we get W by 2 into L minus W in WL by 2. Right? So from this WL by 2 minus WL by 2. So both are get cancelled. So moment at B is equals to 0. Right? Moment at A is also 0. Moment at B is also 0. That means it is perfectly in equilibrium condition. So the M will distribute to reaction A and reaction B. The load is supported by the two reactions. So now we'll try to draw bending moment and shear force diagram. That is the fourth step. Step number 4, shear force and bending moment diagram, right? This is the important point, important step. Let's take the free body diagram of the beam, okay, acting if load at middle of the span. This is length L by 2, L by 2, and the total length will be L, right? Clear? Now just extend these lines to draw shear force and bending moment. First, draw the baseline . This is the baseline. So we got shear force at, that is FA equals to W by 2. That means it is positive. So raise the value of shear force diagram certain height, and there is no change till point C. So this is point C, A and B. That means it will go constant, then at point C the shear force will be changing and it is going into negative. So we know that above the baseline we will draw the positive shear force value, and below that we are drawing negative. That means L by 2 minus L by 2 till it reaches to point B, point A and C. So this will be negative. So this is our shear force diagram for simply supported beam and loading at middle of the beam. Now we'll try to draw the bending moment diagram. Bending moment diagram will be a triangle shape. Draw a baseline first. okay, then point A, it is 0 at point A and point B. That is MA equals to 0 and MB is equals to 0. At point C, that is here, it is WL by 4. That means it will raise till here, then here. So this is positive. If it is negative, we draw below the baseline. So this is bending moment diagram for simply supported beam acting subjected to point load at middle of the beam. So this is positive, that is W L by 4. This is shear force diagram, right?